I was never in the same room with those cockroaches. I did all the effects involving the roaches, but I was never in the same room. I was looking through a window into a sealed room, and I'd say, cue the blood, cue the roaches. And the entomologists who collected the roaches were filling up big syringes underneath E.G. Marshall's dummy and then plunging the plunger on the syringe to force the roaches to come out of his mouth. And there were so many roaches, they got jammed. And it was like a huge roach mound that suddenly was coming out. That didn't work. We had to wait until individual roaches came out, and that was a good take, before we moved to the chest. And I was burned out. I could not figure out how to get the roaches to come out of E.G. Marshall's chest. And George suggested, why don't you just make the hole already and just cover it with toilet paper, which is what we did. We covered it with toilet paper, sprayed it with makeup to look like E.G. Marshall, and the roaches just ate through the toilet paper. It was so easy to pump roaches through wet toilet paper because I had blood tubes in there spraying blood toward the toilet paper, which would cover the roaches with blood, so when they came out, they left little bloody roach footprints, okay?
We didn't know what to expect. We had sealed the room as good as we could. We were all standing outside of it. We had several camera positions on it. And we really didn't know how spectacular it would be, and he really stepped up.
That's wonderful.
Camera's rolling.
It was amazing, and I'm sure we were obliged to exterminate these roaches at the end because they were imported. They were illegal aliens. So we were obliged to exterminate them, but I'm sure that when we wrap the show that there's still roaches crawling around Monroeville somewhere.